Assalamualaikum and good morning everyone. Okay, how are you all today? Thank you for coming. So this will be our second committee meeting for our project Perhentian Kecil. Before I start, I would like to make a roll call. We have Mr. Firdaus from R&D department, Ms. Hanim Shaira from Marketing and Accounting Department, and this is my secretary, Nurul Natasha. And my name is Rashida, your chairperson for today. So I believe that all of you have already received the notice from of meeting from secretary, and there's an agenda inside the notice of meeting. I would like you to quickly go through the agenda. Okay. The first agenda will be the confirmation of the previous meeting. Then you will have matter arising, new proposal to increase profit, and last but not least, for any other business. So I would like to start the meeting now by confirmation of the previous meeting. So I believe that you already read the previous minute that my secretary had just sent to you all. Is there any amendments to make, to be made?
Excuse me, Ms. Chairperson. The total cost of this project is supposed to be 250 million instead of 240 million.
Okay, so Ms. Natasha?
Sorry, Ms. Chairperson. I think there is an error in the venue for our project. Okay. It is supposed to be on Pulau Perhentian Kecil instead of Pulau Perhentian Besar.
Okay, next.
Sorry to interrupt, Ms. Chairperson. I think there is an error. Pulau Perhentian is approximately 21 kilometers from Kuala Besut, instead of 40 kilometers from Kuala Terengganu.
Okay, please take note about that. Now, anything else? Okay, so there are basically two errors.
And is Kuala Besut changed to?
No, it is Kuala Terengganu changed to Kuala Besut, and 40 kilometers changed to 21 kilometers.
Okay, please take note about that. Okay. Now, anything else?
No.
No? Okay, so if there is no more correction regarding the last minute, could someone please propose the minute to be passed?
I propose that the minute to be passed.
I'm second that.
Okay, Ms. Secretary, it is proposed by Mr. Burgos and seconded by Ms. Honey. Okay, next, let's move to the next agenda. Beside that, I would like to highlight some problem that we have discussed from the last meeting. First of all, it's the transportation and the accessibility from the mainland to the island. Second problem, we will have, there is only a few foot trail, basically no roads in the island. Third problem, our dependent on diesel generators for electricity, and the fourth problem is the lack of accommodation. So, Mr. Pedros, could you brief us the progress about the transportation from the mainland to the island?
Okay, thank you, Ms. Jefferson. As for now, for the transportation between the mainland to the island, we are proposing to develop a cable car as there are many benefits that can be obtained from the development of cable car in our Perhentian Kecil project, which is the first one is to lower down the labor cost, as the users of cable car can cut down the cost that can be used to spend on driver, for example, because no driver are needed to operate the cable car. Moreover, it also can give tourist experience in enjoying the journey from the mainland to the Pulau Perhentian Kecil, and it also can shorten the time compared to by users of boats.
May I interrupt? What do you mean by shorten the time? Are you sure? Because the cable car actually will move slowly.
Yes, it will move slowly, but considering a few other things, such as the cable car traveling in mid-air, which wave and sea condition can be neglected. Besides, tourists also will be immersed with the journey, and they will feel that the journey are shorter compared when they are traveling by boat.
Sorry for interruption. I got a better solution. Why don't we build a bridge instead? The tourists can use their own car and reach the island faster compared to the cable car.
Sorry for interrupting. I don't think that is a very good and practical idea, as it requires a huge investment. In addition, building a bridge across a sea require a lot of commitment and maintenance, as we are dealing with wave, current, and high costs are required as well.
Okay, how about the cable car? Is it also need to build the post to the sea? It also need high maintenance, right?
Oh, yes. I'm sorry about that. I think I've lacked consideration of that matter, and I will get back another time.
Okay, Mr. Pedros. So, anyone else have any idea about the transportation? No? Yes, Mr. Pedros?
Sorry to interrupt. I also suggest that since there are no road and only foot trail available in Pulau Perhentian Kecil, and during monsoon especially, those foot trail will be very muddy and will cause difficulties for the tourists to travel around, to move around, as the mud will make them dirty, and this will make them disinterest in exploring the island, especially during monsoon.
Okay, so what does it mean when they are out? Pardon me. Okay, I'm afraid that I have to stop you from that first, because from the previous item, which is transportation, we did not come into agreement yet. So in case like that, since we have no agreement on the transportation, I would like to suggest the item of again during next meeting. So Mr. Pedros, you can further research on that and present on the next meeting.
Okay.
Next, we proceed about build the road. But how about environmental issue? It will actually generate a lot of waste when building the road. Have any of you take any consider about this matter?
Actually, I have already considered all those factors when coming out from the plan, and already came up with a few contingency plan as well as impact assessment. That I believe this project will have a very controlled amount of waste generated, and in case of uncontrolled amount, those will be properly handled and will be disposed in a very controlled area.
Okay, since that building road is so essential to bring up the development of the island, so everyone agree on the building of the road?
Yes.
So, okay, we will further build more roads to ease every transportation within the island and everything. However, Mr. Bildos, yes. Make sure you monitor the waste generate and take precaution step when building the road. Proper disposal should be our main priority.
Okay.
Okay, since that no problem, we agree on the road, so we will build more road. Okay, next, we would like to discuss about our third item. Okay, Mr. Pudos.
Sorry, Ms. Jefferson. Since we already decided to build road, so I think we can add transportation services, such as cart services.
Okay, so now you would like to suggest additional recommendation after we build the road. So your recommendation is?
I recommended that we provide transportation service such as cart service into our project, as those services can help our tourists to transport their luggage from the jetty to the hotel or to the chalet.
Okay,
come.
Excuse me.
Yeah,
I agree with Mr. Ferdows about the cart, but maybe we can encourage some bicycle.
Oh, good idea.
Maybe we can make bicycle renting, because some of the tourists come here is by ship and they don't transport with them.
I totally agree with Ms. Hanim. If we provide both cart and bicycle, we can help to increase our company profit. And it is pollution free, right?
Yes. And more environmentally friendly, and maintenance cost is lesser.
Yes.
Oh, so just to clarify that your car will be using electricity or using fuel, since it is environmental friendly.
Yes, it will be absolutely 100% depending on electricity. And plus, we might provide various type of bike, like the one with babysitter or couple bike for married couple to enjoy their view together in this island.
Oh, cool. Since we agree with that, so we shall move to the next item that we shared from our last meeting about the electricity, that we only depend on diesel generator, which is a cause of contamination to the environment. So regarding that, Mr. Pedros, so what is your finding?
Yes, Ms. Chairwoman, Chairperson, Pulau Perhentian Kecil currently are still depending on diesel generator to create electricity. I suggest that instead of using diesel generator, we may use solar energy to produce electricity.
May I interrupt? Yep. Solar, what do you mean by we use solar energy?
As we all know, Terengganu can be said are blessed with sunlight. We can utilize those benefit, those sunlight to generate electricity by installing solar panel in Pulau Perhentian Kecil, and the development of Western technology also has integrated capacitor into a solar panel that those can help to store electric that will make the uses of solar panel are practicable even during the absence of sunlight, especially during rainy season or during night.
Sorry for interrupt, Mr. Chairperson, but I disagree with Mr. Prodo's idea to get energy from solar, because since we get energy from solar, it involves a high technology equipment. Besides that, we need to consult an expertise for installment. Furthermore, the maintenance fee is too high for the long term running. The cost will be higher than what we thought.
Sorry for less consideration for the cost. How about a change of plan? Instead of using solar energies for the generation of electricity, how about we use another resources such as wind or the water? We can install a water or wind turbine in order to produce electricity, and I believe those will have a lower cost compared to the users of solar panel in the island. And I will further doing research and will come back with the prospect again.
Good idea. Okay, maybe you need to summarize the cost that you can propose during next meeting. So, any comment for the electricity generator?
It's quite a good idea.
It is because it's an island. Island usually windy, so I think it's a very good idea.
Okay, so since everyone agreed, so our electricity will be using water and turbine. Okay, now next item will be the accommodation. As I read from the previous meeting, the idea of the 5-star hotel has been rejected due to the environmental issues as well as the budget. So, Ms. Han, how do you think about the case?
So far as I know, there is only 20 chalet in Pulau Perhentian Kecil. If the expansion of tourist industry, it's for sure that 20 chalet will not enough cover the demands of accommodation. So I suggest that to build more chalet and upgrade the existing chalet. I also provide something special to the tourists. For example, we build the houses or chalet above the sea, and this can help to attract the tourists and help them to create new experience.
Sorry for interrupting, Ms. Hanim. I'm afraid I have to disagree with your point on building sea houses, as those things require high maintenance and might be not stable, especially in Pulau Perhentian current wave situation, and any accident occur can risk life of our tourists. Besides, instead of doing sea houses, I suggest that we can upgrade our chalet, our already existing chalet and facilities, so that our tourists will feel more like home. This, I believe, can be done by improving our interior design, interior decoration, for example.
So your upgrade is more increased facility and design.
Yep.
But I need to guide you back to right track, because now we are having less amount of houses and chalet instead of increasing the design. Can we increasing the amount of chalet?
I have do a research on constructing chalet, and I have idea for constructing the new chalet to cover the demand for incoming tourists. At first, I wish to incorporate the idea of One Malaysia in our new Shelly because Malaysia is popular with characteristic of different race to be an attractive point for foreign who want come to experience different culture in Malaysia. Besides that, I have an idea to put the Shelly on the tree. There are also some countries put their Shelly on the tree in the preserved jungle. And this is very attractive point for everyone to come and stay in Shelly on the tree.
Sorry for interrupting again. Do you think that the tree are stable enough to hold both Shelly?
From my research on the place, the tree are big enough. Furthermore, there are many countries have put their Shelly on the tree, and I believe that the professional able to maintain the stability of the Shelly.
Excuse me, I would like to interrupt. When we built the Shelly on the tree, what about the Wi-Fi? Wi-Fi is important for the society. Will you incorporate Wi-Fi on the tree house?
Since my idea is want to them experience and enjoy the nature, so I do not consider Wi-Fi would be the things that are needed.
So it's more like to connect to nature instead of connect to their phone.
Yes.
I do agree with Ms. Hanim. Maybe we can provide a Wi-Fi hotspot in a certain area only, for example in a restaurant, so that they can still connect with their phone and as well connecting to the nature. And one more interruption, since you want to build a tree house, how do you ensure the safety of the tourists, of the occupant of their houses during night, especially as animals such as snake can sleep into the house?
Okay, since we want to build Shelly on the tree, so to ensure the safety of our tourists, from my research, and I know that when they want to build the Shelly on the tree, they have to fence around the area to prevent the entry of animals. In Pulau Perhentian, the snake is not dangerous and we can provide clinic there. But the safety factor is very important, so I will take consider on it.
Okay, so I would like to refresh the idea of Miss Honey, which is to build more chalet. First of all, build more chalet on the land with different culture characteristic, which is point of attraction. Besides that, you also like to build more chalet on tree. So regarding the safety on chalet, we have to look deeper into safety issues on that area and how we can prevent wild animals coming into the protecting area. So during the next meeting, you have to propose your research on that. Regarding to Wi-Fi suggested by my secretary, we agree that we do not build Wi-Fi in jungle chalet. As suggested by Mr. Firdaus, we build Wi-Fi in restaurant. What I mean is in a centralized place, so you all agree with that?
Yes.
That is great. Without any further, we move to the next agenda, which is the new proposal for increasing profit. So based on your research, what do you find? So let's start with Ms. Hani.
Okay, from my point of view, in order to increase our company profit, I suggest that we develop our existing F&B, food and beverage sector. So I suggest that we can bring in more variety of food so we can offer more international food to our tourists, such as Japanese food, Thailand food, French food, and other things. This can offer more choice and also suit to different types of tourists.
I do agree with Ms. Hanim's idea. However, I think it could be better if we do promote our local cuisine as well. For example, Terengganu itself has a lot of food that I believe will suit the taste of a lot of our tourists, such as nasi dagang, keropok leko, where at the same time we can promote Terengganu and Malaysia as well. Besides, we also can hold food festival that I believe can attract tourists into coming to Perhentian Kecil Island.
Besides that, I have idea to operate a boat restaurants. Since we can fully utilize our asset and resources, so we can operate a restaurant.
Sorry for interrupting. I don't think that's a very good idea, as some of the tourists might have difficulties to enjoy their food, as some of them might have seasick, and it is very important for them to have a very enjoyable meal time.
I agree with Mr. Firdaus. For example, if have one gang of friends, they will go together. If one of them have problem with seasick, they may not enjoy the food together. In my opinion, I think it is a good point to create attractive boat to attract people more.
We can further discuss it if this idea is passed.
So before that, we should put it into a boat whether we should create a boat restaurant or not. For those in favor of boat restaurant, please raise your hand. Okay, we have to agree that we will create a boat restaurant to increase our profit. So we will end our meeting. Anything else you want to bring up?
No.
So if there is no other matter to discuss, Ms. Secretary, would you like to brief us on the detail of the next meeting? So everyone agree with that? So everyone okay?
Yes.
Okay, we shall see you 2 weeks from now at meeting room PPSMS at 2 p.m. Okay, we can conclude our meeting today, and thank you for coming everyone, and the meeting is adjourned.
Nak tanya, memang lepas Syida cakap secretary brief tu, memang secretary tak cakap pun?
Cakap okey je.
Okey je.
Cakap okey.
Cakap okey
sendiri. Tak apa.
Tak apa.
And I'm going to talk to
you. Okey lah tu.